Yeah, we're late. We're gonna start soon.
This is much better.
A lot of them are A lot of them are.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much. Welcome, everyone. Welcome back and welcome guests. Welcome to the San Francisco Mandarin English Tulsa Bilingual Club. My name is Alan Wu, and I'm the president of the club. Okay, and later on, we have a very, very good show for you. So just try to be ready for it. Okay, but right now, I would like you to ask you to please silence your cell phone at this point. Thank you so much. And if you have a smartphone, go ahead checking on the Facebook saying yeah, in Tulsa Mandarin Club. Alright. So did you guys all have a nice weekend?
Yep.
Yeah? It looked pretty wet out there, right? What'd you do, Nicola?
Remember we had lunch on
Sunday. Oh. For which I was not invited. Okay.
What?
Oh, I was invited.
I heard of was sent email. Invited.
Oh, I didn't get the email.
It was invited.
You was invite.
Yes.
I'm really gonna get an email. I feel like I can't tell the group what's going on here. Marco, what'd you do over the weekend?
That's a good question. Do some house cleaning.
Read some good books. Oh yeah. What book you want to share?
Yes, I read one of my old books, The Road Less Traveled by Scott Peck.
Oh, that sounds like a really interesting book.
Yeah, it is. Check it out. I recommend it. It came out in 1930s. It was one of the all-time bestseller lists, both not by advertising but words of mouth.
Interesting. Next time bring it over, see if we can get something out of it. Nice. Okay, I see we have some new faces in the audience today. So at this time, I'd like you to ask you to stand up and say your name and say how you found out about the club and what your expectation for the club. So why don't we start with you?
My name is Grace, and I just got my CC, I think, a month ago. But I got a new job in San Francisco, so I'm searching for new clubs.
All right. Congratulations.
Thanks.
What's CC?
Company
community. You finished the whole
CC can mean a lot of things, right?
Credit
card.
You need to come out here now.
Holidays.
That's right.
Go ahead, Grace.
Go ahead, Grace. Yeah.
I visited the Silicon Valley one, and since I was job hunting at the time, was hesitant to commit to a new Toastmasters club when I was job hunting for a new job. So the Mainer English one in Silicon Valley. I'm here.
That's great. Welcome.
And hi, Allison. And we have Thomas, would you please stand up?
Hi. I am still learning more about what you guys do here. I learned Mandarin. So I grew up in New York, and I studied Mandarin there. And then I moved to Beijing and studied Mandarin in Beijing for 2 years. And I want to keep my skills up.
Can
you
all
find
out the guys on meetup.com?
Yes.
Okay. Welcome.
How long did you study the Mandarin in New York?
In New York? 2 years, but I felt like I didn't really learn much there.
So total 4 years, right? With Beijing 2 years.
Yeah.
So we're expecting you to come out here to do the whole speech in Mandarin, right? Just like a pressure's already on. He's like, oh, no.
No, his Mandarin is not bad.
Yeah.
It's better than mine.
Yeah. Okay, and the gentleman sits right next to you. What is your name?
Oh, hi, my name is Paul. This is my second meeting. I was here maybe 4 weeks ago. I haven't joined yet, but I probably eventually will. So I'm originally from New York too. I took last year I started to get interested in Chinese because it's so important now for business and stuff. So I took 2 years of Chinese, traditional Chinese in Los Angeles. And then I moved up to Bay Area earlier this year, so I'm looking to
Yes. This is only for
or half a newspaper.
Right. That's a good goal. Yeah, welcome. Yeah.
Welcome, Paul.
Anybody else?
Sherry.
Oh, yeah, Sherry, yeah. Well, it's been a year now? Just kidding.
Just about.
Just about, yeah. Feels like it, yeah. Well, welcome, everybody. And we're ready to move on to our program now. So the first thing is we're going to introduce the Toastmaster for tonight. We're going to go ahead and introduce our memory Toastmaster first, which is our lovely Kayla. Let's go ahead and give her a hand. English Toastmaster is you're truly me, Alan Wu. Very good working Angeles. And today we're actually going to do something different. We actually came out, well, not me, but Elliot and the president of Other Mandarin English Toastmaster Club, they put in a lot of effort to come out with some sort of script for us. Just have us to try it out to see how it works out. It's a really good script. Today will be the first time that we'll incorporate this, so there might be some hiccup here and there, just bear with us. But we think this will be a very good for the club, so that's why we're going to go ahead and start using this today. So with that being said, Kayla, please take it away.
Oh, 刚才Alan介绍的，我是中文主持人，他是英文主持人。然后每次会议呢，我们都练习三种演讲。第一种呢是事先准备好的演讲，就是prepare speeches， 演讲员用一两个星期呢来准备5到7分钟的演讲，当然第一个演讲是4到6分钟。第二种演讲呢就是即兴演讲，每个人都可以参加，也许你是新人，也有机会可能会被问到。 然后即兴演讲呢，就是主持人问一个问题，你呢给1到2分钟的答案。第三种呢，就是评估，我们给演讲员反馈哪些地方好，哪些地方需要改进，这个一般是2到3分钟。而且呢，我们今天晚上还有每个很多人担任不同的职责，首先他们比如说是文法官啦、哼哈官、时间官。 首先，我们请文法官来给我们讲每日一次，并告诉我们他的角色。今天的文法官是重缺，
今天我们其实没有文法官。
哦，我们今天没有文法官，那就由我们两个来讲一下今天的 theme word of the day.
Word of the day. Okay, but before we move on to that, we're just going to use the English part of it, just to say that really quick. Okay, so. Good evening, fellow Toastmaster, and the most welcome guest. Okay, welcome to the Mandarin English Toastmaster. I'm your Mandarin Toastmaster for the evening, and I'm your English Toastmaster. Okay, so at every meeting, we will be practicing 3 different types of speeches. The first kind is called the prepared speeches, where people will be giving some time, maybe a week or two, or maybe a day or two, to prepare 5 to 7 minutes of talk. The second type is called a spontaneous speeches. Everyone can join. Okay? Table topic masters ask a question, then you will give it a 1 or 2 minute to answer. And the third type is the evaluations. This is where our speakers will be given feedback on how well they did and areas for improvements. Now, of course, the meeting will not be complete without some of the members that's going to be taking roles and, of course, taking roles and helping us with the meeting. We would like to introduce them right now. First of all, we would like to invite our grammarian, which we actually don't have a grammarian for today. But if anybody would like to volunteer themselves to be a grammarian for today, this is time to raise your hand. Anybody? Ursula? Okay, so, okay, Ursula, thank you very much. Okay, so Ursula will be our grammarian and a timer at the same time. Ursula, would you please stand up and maybe just explain what your role is as a grammarian and a timer?
So the grammarian is essentially someone who's listening for different things that we can improve in both languages. I'll mainly be focusing on English, and if there's a volunteer for Chinese, I would love to have a partner. If there's anyone who wants to do that, chance. Otherwise, we'll stick to English.
Great, thanks.
I'll obviously report this in two halves. I'll start with the English, and you can follow up with the Mandarin when we report back. And I'm going to be looking for things that we can clean up in language. So that's basically a summary of that. Out of my next role as a timer, I'm going to be using these cards for each speaker, not only for the prepared speech, but the table topics. For the prepared speeches, I will show you the green card at 5 minutes, the yellow card at 6 minutes, and the red card at 7 minutes. There's also evaluation here, so I guess I will show that as well, but I want to talk about the timing of the table topics first. The green means 1 minute, the yellow means 1.5 minutes, and the red is 2 minutes. And evaluation is slightly longer. The green is 2 minutes, the yellow is 2.5, and the red is 3.
Okay, thank you. Let's go ahead and you say that one more time in Chinese. Okay.
Unnecessary fillers such as and even things like. I will be listening to repetitive words like and so. Be very careful, these are very short. And I was also listening for them in Chinese too. Zigga zigga nigga nigga nigga.
Thank you. All you.
今天的 theme， 今天的主题就是 winter holiday， 因为冬天来了嘛，你看又下雨，前几天又刮大风又下大雨，真是冻得不得了，真是觉得 winter 来到了。但是 winter 身上很冷，可是因为我们有很多 holiday， 有 Christmas， 有 New Year，我们一庆祝呢，心里却很温暖，所以呢，我们就想到放 winter holiday 做今天的主题。然后呢，在 winter holiday 时候呢，大家会做什么呢？ 亲朋好友，他就聚在一起吃喝玩乐，所以就叫 gathering 聚会，所以就今天的词就是聚会。所以在你今天无论是 prepared speech 呢，还是 table topic speech 的时候呢，你都可以用这两个字 winter holiday 或者是
gathering
或者是冬季假期或者是聚会都可以。然后我们就会 ring the gong。好，谢谢。
So let me go ahead and say that in English really fast. So our theme of the day is winter holidays. Obviously, we're right now in the winter season. Just like Kayla mentioned earlier, it's starting to rain now. And if you go to the mountain, I'm sure there's going to be snow, which I just came back 2 weeks ago, perfect condition. Winter, of course, winter comes with a lot of holidays, such as Thanksgiving, Christmas, of course, New Year as well. Every time we have holidays, always family get together. We celebrate this holiday all together. And even though it's very cold outside, the way family members get all together is very warm feeling inside. So that's why our word of the day for today will be gathering. Okay? It means everybody coming together and be one. Okay? Be as a celebrating as one family. Now, the purpose of it is to see if you can incorporate these ideas into your prepared speeches or your table topic. Every time you use the word gathering or winter holidays, you want to go ahead and hit the gown and just to prove that, hey, you pay attention and you try to incorporate that into the speech. So that's the theme for the word of the day.
Mr. Robert Chen. His theme is to be or not to be.
Well, before today's first speaker, so right now we're going to move on to the next portion, which is the prepared speeches. Our first speaker is a very seasoned speaker. His name is Robert Tran. He's actually a VP of the second, VP of Education of the club. Okay, and then to evaluate his speech, we have Sue. So Sue, would you please stand up, state the objective of Robert's speech for today.
So tonight his speech, the purpose of the speech is, where is it? He'll proceed with power. So he's going to proceed us with power. This is Project 9, I'm going to evaluate him, evaluate his speech.
Thank you, Sue. So before we introduce each speaker, we usually ask speakers if there's any short introduction that you would like us to say before we prompt the speaker's end. And today, he emailed me and said that the introduction he wants me to put out is, please pay attention or you can go to jail if you don't. Is that right? Okay. So let's go ahead and welcome Robert.
To be, that is the question. Of course, this quote came from Shakespeare's Macbeth, and it simply means, do you want to live or not? A person's life is sometimes determined not by himself or herself. Well, you might ask, how's that possible? It is possible if you serve on the jury. Tonight, I'm going to tell you that the American jury system is flawed. It's flawed. I'm going to give you three reasons why it's flawed. And I hope by the end of the speech, you also see it in my point of view. So the first reason is bias. We all come from different walks of life. We all bring with us different experience. We all talk about this person's skin color or the height, the weight, whatnot. And we carry these sort of experience with us into the courtroom, sitting on the jury. And we need to determine whether a person is innocent or guilty simply by saying, based on what the evidence presents to them. But sometimes, our bias comes into play. Allow me to share an experience with you. I was on the jury about 2 years ago on a case of wrongful termination. The defendant was an African American, and the company that fired him was run by a white company, like a white people's company. So what happened was, when the case took about a month and a half to complete, when it was completed, 12 people went behind the deliberation. Right away, three women raised their hand and said that he shouldn't deserve the money that he should deserve. Later on, when we went through the evidence, and it was really clear and convincing that the company did wrongfully terminate this individual, but it didn't change the mind of those three individual who raised their hand in the first place. So what does that say? It says that our bias really plays into the decisions that we make. Now, I was on the wrongful termination case, but can you imagine if you're on a case where you have to decide whether you should put that person alive in prison or hang them? Well, that makes a big difference because our bias plays into this whole situation. Number two, intelligence. Now surely God is pretty equal, right? There's smart people, dumb people. It's all walks of life. But funny enough, when you sit in the jury, there are all different types of people. People could reason, people couldn't reason. You have 19-year-old people or maybe 80-year-old lady sitting on the jury. And so in order to determine whether certain evidence are plausible or not, you have to be able to deduce these evidence. And if you cannot deduce in a way that can give a fair trial to the person, how fair is it to the defendant? Surely it's not fair at all. So one could imagine that if there are people in the jury, say doctors, lawyers, but then there's kids, old people, those who are not as convincing, but there are those who could convince other people. Can you imagine? It could be just a few people that decides the fate of that defendant, not as a whole 12 people. So unless you have certain intelligence to deduce or to reason all the evidence that are being presented to you, there is no way that you could defendant a fair trial. And last but not least, the third reason is convoluted jury instructions. I'm sure you're all aware of by the end of the trial, the judge will present you with a stack of instructions. And the judge is going to tell you, you're supposed to include Exhibit A, but not Exhibit B. You're supposed to listen to a certain part of the evidence, but you're supposed to ignore the other. How is it possible for us to just walk into the deliberation, follow the judge's instruction, and be able to determine what we should include in our mind and what we shouldn't include in our mind? Because if we are supposed to follow the instruction clearly of what the judge said, it would be really difficult because we would be boxed in to what we should or shouldn't do. And if we want to be fair to the defendant, shouldn't it be leaving it up to us to decide whether, rather than being boxed into certain instructions? So, in summary, our bias, the intelligent, and convoluted instructions really put this system, this jury system, into a flawed state. Now, if we can't beat the system, surely it's not going to change because just you and I can go up to the judge and say, you know what, I don't think this is fair. Well, you have to sit on it then. If you can't beat the system, what are you going to do? You've got to find ways to go around it. So, if next time you're in trouble, and God forbids that you are in trouble, do the three things. Dress nicely. Present yourself nicely. Number two, tell your lawyers to find compassionate jurors. Not someone who can reason, just compassionate. Because if you find compassionate jurors, most likely they'll be on your side as the defendant. And last but not least, always look at the jurors with puppy eyes. Eyes that you're going to tell them that I am innocent. I'm not guilty. Don't find me guilty. So with that, I hope you feel that you're being, that you feel the same way that I do. Thank you.
A very informative speech. That puppy eyes yet? No, didn't work. Okay. Very well. Okay. Thank you very much for your wonderful speeches. Now we're moving on to the next one.
下面一位演讲员呢，他是一位资深会员，他叫 Alberto。
To bring out that when you come to the meeting, please bring your booklet with you because the book is somewhat that can keep you on track of what you have already done and also how many speeches have been done. Because everybody has an end goal, right? We all want to be a competent communicator or competent leadership, and the book is a really good tool for us to keep on track with that. Okay. And,
You want me to meet the online? Okay. The objective of this speech is to select an appropriate online outline which allows listeners to easily follow and understand your speech. Number two, make your message clear with supporting material directly contributing to that message. And thirdly, use appropriate transitions when moving from one idea to another. And lastly, create a strong opening and conclusion.
Thank you, Mike. Not yet, okay. on to the next one?
Yes.
Okay, so we'll come back to Alberto after this short. Okay, we're going to go ahead and skip on to our last speaker for the day. Okay, for now, yeah.
Okay. Okay. 这个好像是一个常用的一句话改编的，他把常说的一句话改了，然后我已经好像还没听他的演讲已经被 inspired 了，所以我希望，Sherry 呢，他说他最喜欢的事情呢就是旅行，他的梦想呢就是有一天可以走遍全世界，他最近刚从秘鲁回来，That's why 我说他是很久违的 Sherry， 这是他第二次去南美洲。 这次的经历有点与众不同，因为有几次他尝试生命危险，可是 Sherry 并没有因此而放弃他想继续旅行的心愿。下面就让我们来听听他对旅行、对人生有什么意义。谢谢。
So before we ask Sherry to come out, let's go ahead and ask Sherry's evaluator, which is
Barry.
Would you please stand up and state the objective for this speech so we know what to do for?
今天是 Sherry 的第十个演讲，这是终极演讲CC的最后一个演讲单元。单元的目标就是要激励听众，呼吁他们能够达到更高的理想，然后能用有趣的故事、引言或是趣闻来增加戏剧性，满足听众的需求，迎合他们的情感。好，那我们就来听听
Sherry 会不会达到这些目标。
Okay, let's welcome
Sherry. 那个 Andrew Canyon 就是那个羚羊场。
这一天到地后，所以在去秘鲁之前呢，我几乎没有做什么的准备，直到最后一个星期我才开始去买一些需要的东西，然后整一个计划我都丢给我朋友，因为他们也帮我计划。然后之前我确实有去爬山，然后觉得自己本身的身体条件应该还不错，因为经常有做锻炼，想想然后我有很多朋友他们也去过那个地方，所以我觉得我应该没有问题，而且我是已经身经百战，在去秘鲁之前我已经去过世界上几乎50多个国家 It's just another destination， 所以就觉得没有问题就去吧，反正不管山有多高我都可以到那目的地。但是当我真正到了那边的时候，当我必须用3天靠着自己的双脚走整整67公里的时候，我才觉得天真的天外有天，人外有人。然后很多人有说到那边会有高山的反应。It's actually 10 minutes. It's 10 minutes.
Oh,
for the speech.
谢谢你。
So that's 4 minutes.
Five.
Okay.
I'll give you one at 8.
Okay. Thank you. Andes 斯山脉是全世界最长的一个山脉之一。那我所去爬的一座山，它是南美洲最高的一座雪山，叫做 Salcantay。它是处于在海平面6800米之上，在美国并没有那么高的平面。然后我之前也从来没有去过那么高的地方。很多人会说你可以在这边买药，或者是说到了当地可以去吃用当地人的，就是用当地人的方法，他们会咬那个可可因的叶子，然后我并没有带任何的药物，因为我对西方的药物觉得有点反常，所以我就说我就一直就在那边咬一些的叶子，咬了很多叶子，然后刚才说的是13天的，在第一天的时候，我们必须爬过最长的一段时间，要走整整20个公里，然后要跨越一座2000米的山。走到一半的时候，我的肺就完全不听自己的使唤，就在那边喘气喘得非常厉害。无论我咬了多少的那个叶子，但是我还是觉得就是局部困难。所以那一次，然后我就开始就觉得我已经在这边了，然后我的目的地是要寻找平静，在这时候放弃呢还是继续呢？但是既然你们都来了这个地方，就没有办法放弃，所以我放弃了我爬山的愿望。我叫我的导游给了我一匹马，然后我就骑马骑了1个小时来到我们第一天晚上住的露营。那我这一次并不是一个人去旅行，我还跟另外
1 minute right now, just go ahead, write down the critique or evaluation for Sherry. Give it 1 minute. So now we're looking for the next speaker. For your presence, Alberto? Sure, yeah, okay. This is a good time for me to introduce your next speaker. He's also a very seasoned speaker. He's actually one of the mentors of this club. It's because his contribution to the club, our club, is so successful and we have a very strong foundation. And he's very inspiring and uplifting. Every time he says something, walk away with a point or two that's to stay with you, apply to your life. And yeah, would you like to say something about Alberto? Yeah. Today, his title is A Moment of the Truth. A lot of times, we always think that as ourselves, we have been doing a very, very good job. You know, like we always think that we're just chopping along until we hit the wall and we know that that's the moment of truth. And a lot of times, the moment of truth is the time that you can reflect yourself to see what kind of improvement you can make, or some kind of the critique or constructive feedback that other people can give you so you can move forward. Hey, Alberto, we're really running out of stuff to say here. So are you ready for your speech?
I like those moments too, you know.
Okay, all right. It's coming. So it looks like everything is just falling in the right place right now.
Let's welcome Alberto.
Okay, let's welcome Alberto.
Today, Alan asked everybody, what do you do in the weekend? To me, was a moment of truth. And then he asked to the new members, introduce yourself. It was also another moment of truth. Robert talked about justice. And also, is very truth. So it's easy to look at sometimes. To talk about truth, and probably during the winter holidays, your supervisor, your significant other, your boss, your friend will ask for moment of truth. But the point today is not about philosophy of the truth. It's about those masters. It's about how the truth and those masters can change the directions. This is the Asian representation of the goddess, truth. She's holding a mirror and a snake. Think about it. A mirror and a snake. Other times, we see politicians taking the truth about my way, on your freeway. Toastmaster has engineered the program so well that we go through two different processes how to evaluate ourselves as a club. And there are 3 points which I want to indicate. One, the club life cycle. If you remember the beginning, we are a lot of people. And after that, we start to see the number decreasing, but we start to see new faces. It's what we call the life cycle of those massive clubs. It's happening in companies, and family, everything changes, it's a cycle. And then we need to identify problems and how to resolve as a team. It's not a one-person job. It's not a vice president or the president. Everybody needs to work as a team. And finally, we need to develop an action plan. What to do? Probably when you talk to your supervisor, you go through the same questions. Those masters teach you those simple rules. And sometimes you don't figure out what. Just try to use the I Chi as a prototype and how the life cycle in the club change. For those who knows about it, I Chi is a numerical system. So we started here, which was really hard to collect 20 members. And then we went through two different processes: learning, recruiting members, creating leadership, making influence on the people, making progress, working together, pushing, you know, just winning, succeed, winning, whatever, to develop ourselves. Raising candidates, persuasive influence, and be focused. Ideally, we need to reach this point and be able to expand, because it's what we call a healthy club. But if we reach that point, we can say this group is successful. However, there are many factors that can shape the direction of the club. Conflict. Stagnation, decline, clicking, you know, people go together, get closed, they don't get able to penetrate new members, no participation, and sometimes create problems.
finally, the clock died. Simple word, died. People do not have more interest in anything. This happens in business, in your corporation, in your startup, in any place. Here's the first group of people who start, I call the pioneers, the entrepreneurs. And probably you will see many faces who are not here today. What is really important is to rely on membership and leadership go together. It's not only the leaders, the members also are leaders. I need to create a rapport between members and leaders. Work as a team to create new faces against critical areas and challenges. And finally, what they call leadership. Different from leadership, we need to shift, create different visions. Here today, everyone has served. I want you to feel it before to go to your house and greet one of the Lord, because this is part of what we call an assessment. And this is really important for us, for future directions. You will say yes or no, one or three, it's easy. And then the leaders and the members need to write down realistic goals, not inventing the wheels. Simple. Recruit volunteers. Make a timetable so the new set of leaders are able to know what's going on. And finally, the rule of the three things. Communicate, communicate, and communicate. Leaders need to be able to communicate to the members, and the members need to be able to communicate to the leaders. Otherwise, the club will get in trouble. Finally, I want to conclude my speech. I just brought 3 points. How to understand the life cycle with just brief words. How to work as a team. And finally, how to develop an action plan. Is anyone recall the bamboo? Bamboo starts with a really tiny root until they, blossom everywhere and create a strong foundation. We are like a bamboo clock. Sound crazy, but who we are, the bamboo clock. Ladies and gentlemen, this is my topic today.
Thank you very much. Very philosophical, wasn't it? Did you walk away with one on your team? Yeah, but you also touched on a very, very good point, which I will bring out later after the meeting. But for now, I know we're running short on time, so we're going to move on to our next segment. So without further ado, we're going to go ahead and introduce our table topic mastery for the English. Let's go ahead and welcome Johan. Thank you, Johan. Johan, would you please use 1 or 2 minutes to state your questions about what we're going to ask? Thank you so much. Well, first off, I want to start off by saying the Toastmasters, you two picked a great theme for today, winter holidays, which I think is a wonderful theme. Winter is one of my favorite times of the year, the winter holidays. You know, you can get together with family and friends inside a cozy, warm environment, maybe have relatives coming from out of town. It's very, very great time. But winter holidays are celebrated by different cultures and by different people. Just about every culture, every group of people around the world celebrates winter holidays, but each of them do it in their own way, with their own cultural traditions that they add to it. So what I want to ask you is, what is your unique way of celebrating the winter holidays, and what are your unique traditions or cultural nuances that you add to your celebrations of the winter holidays that make it special, and what do you do?
Sue? District, so they turn off the light on Christmas Eve, 12 a.m. So it's called Kiss Time. It's romantic. It's very bright, but just turn off every light from the shops and everything.
Thank you, Sue. That's a very interesting. How they celebrate it in Korea. Now I know, I'll have to take my future girlfriend then. Yeah, during the winter holidays. Definitely make it special for her and celebrate over there.
Or go to church.
Or go to church. Well, you know, winter is very special. Its roots, winter holidays, you know, its roots go far back. Many people think of winter holidays as, you know, the meaning of winter holidays is really spending time with family and friends inside your home, you know, sharing good memories, good moments with family and friends and the people you love. But in modern times, one of the most pronounced elements of the holiday season is gift giving. Many people look forward to the holiday season primarily for the gifts that they'll be receiving or the shopping that they're going to do for more gifts. But some people feel that today the holiday season is over-commercialized and that the shopping, you know, really that shopping and receiving gifts is the primary purpose of the holiday season and is taken away from the real meaning of the holiday season, which is, you know, spending time with your friends and family and sharing those good moments. So I want to ask you, do you agree or disagree that the winter holiday season is becoming overly commercialized, and why do you think that way? I'm sorry, I forgot your name in the back.
Thomas.
Would you care to come up and share with us?
Okay, classic.
Anything goes out there.
Yeah, it's okay.
Maybe Paul.
Nice, beautiful, wonderful holiday.
And it should also be sponsored by Target. Toys R Us. Babies R Us. Maybe you should get a bar of chocolate. Let's start small with them. A bar of chocolate for the babies, a new toy for all the kids, and a bottle of champagne. It should be sponsored by Target, Toys R Us, Babies R Us.
Walmart, Costco.
And they should be responsible for all this and make it great PR. And Christmas will be beloved by
thank you, Grace, for sharing with us. I really love your idea. I actually agree with you. I think that we have not over-commercialized all this. All my friends tell me how snappy I am when I don't get my gifts. So for everybody in the room, I love Costco, Alan. Hint, wait. I love Costco, Toys R Us, all that. So one of the biggest elements of the winter holiday season, though, is, and this is the thing that I look forward to every year, the food. The food is by far my favorite part of the holiday season, and a lot of people look forward to it. But there's so many, during holiday season, there's so many different dishes for each different holiday. You know, for example, in America, when they do Halloween, candy is in season. Thanksgiving comes around, and you know, they have turkeys. New Year's, Christmas, they have their own dishes. So each holiday during the winter holiday season has its own special food. Now I want to ask you, what is your favorite dish? And tell us just what it is about your favorite dish that makes it so good, and why I should try it. Marco.
Question is, what is my favorite dish? To do that, I just want to explain that to be true to my character, to me, I'm not as serious about what kind of food that I eat. And more important to me is the company I'm with, the conversation, the relationship. So. And if those are positive, I can be sitting in McDonald's or sitting in wherever, and then I would still enjoy myself. And I think, especially in the spirit of Christmas and holiday, that is enough for me. Thank you.
Thank you, Marco. I feel the same way. I can, you know, the food is very important, but sharing it with people is even more important because it is not fun to eat alone. So let's remember this holiday season, let's just remember to have a good time and, you know, share those moments with our family and friends, and most importantly, have good food and get great gifts. Thank you, Toastmasters.
Thank you so much for such an interesting table topic. And now we're going to move on to a Mandarin table topic.
Today
My manner's not that good.
It's fine, yeah. You can do it in English, right?
Yeah. Come on up.
Maybe Sherry or Barry?
Okay, Sherry.
More Chinese because it's too English heavy. also a meaning. 苹果园, 我们一定要佩服它, 为什么呢? 这个苹果园, 它不但要听, 听了这个演讲的人之后, 它要赶快就想个报告, 研究。 研究以后呢, 很快就要把那个报告造好, 造好, 学好呢, 要上台。 So what I just said briefly is that the evaluator comes up actually is the most challenging of the three parts of the speech. Not only do they need to think fast on their speech and listening to the speech, they have to make a speech right away upon hearing it and then come up here to give a speech about the speech. And we will expect the same thing from them in their evaluation, whether or not they have a beginning, an end, or an end. Whoa, a lot of pressure already. So I'm going to bring up or evaluate that. 现在苹果, Robert, 是, 树, 树, 请你上来给苹果, 我们的 Robert 的演讲。
Robert, now I got another idea of a jury duty. Because my director has just gone to a jury duty today, so she was absent. I was kind of mad, but okay, because it's so busy. But I also got a very bad bad ideas about flow about jury duty. I kind of got frustrated. Who thinks that now the jury duty is bad? Yeah, people got frustrated, and that's why. I can pick up really good points of your speech, like organization of speech was really effective, three reasons. And also I really like the part that your very sarcastic solution really supports and helps your speech, so that we can really get, oh, that must be really bad. So it was related that my fear has having some flaw there. And that's what I thought that's good. And also you use the example and helped for me to draw a picture. There was a guy and we helped judge them or something like that. And if I pick really minor thing, when you summarize, it might be helpful for non-native speakers. Just if you rephrase the word, I didn't get the last one, the instruction. What instruction?
How come?
That one, yeah. That one, so if you can rephrase, that it might help me. And also if you can compare with other better systems in the court, it also can help you to like persuade us. And I always enjoy your diverse topics. If you heard of his speech, then you might be really surprised how diverse and how really big or many, many different topics.
Sherry, 首先恭喜你这第四个演讲，这对我来说是一个非常重要的一个里程，我想对你来说也是一样的，所以你现在得到了西西的终极演讲员的这个资格。其实还没有，我跳过。 到最后的时候，你就是引入到说，其实真正学旅行的原因，不是因为就是说走过千里路或是万里路，那更重要的是说，在阅人，就是说看到不同的，比如说陪伴不同的朋友或者新的朋友，来增加一次。
Albert with his presentation on PowerPoint to help us evaluate Marco. Excuse me, Alberto is Marco. Marco?
Sometimes it is, maybe that's my impression of maybe a little because of my memory doing tricks with me. You know, I have listened to your speech before, you know, so a lot of times smooth words come to mind, and this is the case. It's quite smooth. And secondly, you want to see if the speech, your speech, is clear and there's supporting materials to emphasize your points, and I think I've done that too, very positively and effectively. I like those visual aids, those black and white, and it's very easy to understand, and of course you are a very effective communicator, and everybody seems to understand what you're talking about, and that's which is very good. And in terms of appropriate transition from one idea to the next, and that was, again, may I repeat myself, it was very smooth as well. And in terms of just opening and conclusion, whether you have make a strong statement, and I think, yes, you were giving us a very clear idea of the life cycle of the Toastmasters clubs, which is also why we are here, and we are going through this journey, learning to be a better Toastmasters members, Toastmasters, or better public speakers. And that was very educational as well. And that opens my mind a little bit, and I've learned something from you. You also invite actions. You ask people, you remind them regarding, you know, please fill out the forms, you know, and you know, this is also a good trick to gain people's attention, because as you know, sometimes we daydream and drip in and out, and sometimes we look at our smartphone. And but in conclusion, I think you have done a very good job in terms of, you know, your introduction, your body and conclusion, and you have clearly presented a very effective picture about what you're talking about. If there's any constructive criticism that, you know, I could find is that maybe because of the technical difficulties that you were having, you know, earlier, maybe you could avoid it or prepare it earlier. That would be, that would solve the problem. And overall, it's a very smooth, positive speech, and I'm looking forward to your next speech. I call our timer up to give us a report on how we did with time. And keep it brief, please.
We started the meeting late, and that's something that automatically immediately eats away at time. I did two rolls tonight, and I was using a watch. I would recommend that we have a device that we could probably reuse here, because it was really hard to do the calculation immediately. So I have some rough information and some exact information for you tonight. I started out with Robert. Your speech was targeted for 6 to 4 minutes. You came in at 6 3/4 minutes. Alberto, your speech was targeted for 4 to 6 minutes, and it came in at just under 8. Sherry, yours was 8 to 10, and it ended up as 12.5. The suggestion that I would have for the timer is just, if you have a longer speech, it's helpful to just sort of throw that out. Ultimately, it's my responsibility as a timer to know the length of a speech, but we can always use reminders. That would be one suggestion that I have for that. Johan and Amy, I just combined your times. When one takes more time than the other, you've got to balance that out between the two of you. That's up to you to negotiate as far as I'm concerned tonight, because I had a hard time producing the time. So we've got 12 minutes and three quarter minutes. Sue, yours, wherever she is, was 3 minutes. Grace, 1.5 minutes. Marco, 3/4 of a minute. Barry, 25 seconds. Allison, 1 minute. And the evals were about 2 to 3 minutes, roughly, each, so that was really good. And I can jump right into the grammar and stuff if you'd like. I just do that without the introduction. Robert, I noticed a couple things that a lot of people do in general across many languages. The endings of words are really, really important. ED endings in particular, I heard a drop once, so I didn't know if you were talking about a particular adjective or past tense. One particular word in question was flawed. Flawed, flawed, flawed. You might want to just repeat some of all of the ED ending words just to get that duh or in sound in your speech. I also heard the word God, and I don't know if it was got or God. Got is really smart people, was the expression. So I don't know if that was something that you stumbled due to nerves, but you might want to go back into your speech and see what that was. I thought it was supposed to be got, but I'm not sure. God's forbid, that's an interesting twist on the usual singular God. It's definitely possible, but typically the expression is God forbid. I'm going to jump into Sherry, because you're right next to him on the sheet. You said sorry twice. I think you can say excuse me or just not say it at all. This is something that's also common for a lot of people, where sorry is really like you're at fault for something more than just excuse me. And I think you were really good at adjusting the light situation and the distraction that were in front of you. Rather than saying, can I turn off these lights, just do it. So just address whatever issue is at hand. That goes for anybody. Alberto. I wasn't clear about the I Ching. There wasn't enough definition. So in terms of a grammarian, I didn't really know the context enough to fully understand that slide. And in terms of sound, rapport sounded like report. So I didn't know if you were generating an actual report, but I saw the word, so I knew it was rapport. Grace, a little self-talk. So you asked, can we talk over here? So that was some sort of meta information that you could just remove. That's it for now. Thanks for listening.
That's pretty darn thorough. Thank you, Ursula. And let me call the R counter up here. Charles, Elliot, now! Okay. These are unnecessary fillers, and I'm just going to just quickly name a few of. So that you, by the way, if you actually want to improve yourself, sometimes just go ahead and write it on your speech, however many you had on there, and just watch, track yourself and see whether or not you're getting less and less. That's the ideal, right? So I have a couple of words. Alan had, amazingly, only 4 eyes. Kayla had 0.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Wow.
So with Robert's speech, he had 2 uhs and 1. I actually said there's a category called tongue click. And he had a couple of false starts, meaning we start a sentence, I, when. So we also listened to those. Sue, you were actually called up here twice. Once I forget what. But the table topic had 1 uh, 1 like. You'll be careful of the likes, like that. Sherry, 4 ums. Give me that. Johan, great improvement, only 6.
Yeah.
Wow.
Good morning, Johan.
Wow.
Alberto, 0. Grace had 2 ahs. Amy Lee had 3. Barry had 4. Ursula, 0. Allison had 2 ahs. Those are the unnecessary fillers. So in the interest of time, I'm the general evaluator. I want to quickly sum up there. Speaking of time, Ursula says something that's really, really salient to a meeting. Because we want to honor your time to be here, I want to try to end the meeting on time. However, as general evaluator, in order to make this clip go really well, I do want to zero in on the time issue. We did run a little over time, and it could be handled in a couple ways. Because we are trying bilingual format, and I really like that Alan and Kayla did their best in balancing out, I want to mention that it is not important to do exactly the translation. Just easy. So I did draft a script for the Toastmasters to use as guidance when you get to learn what the contents are. As public speakers, you own those words, they become your words, and then you come up to do that. The reason we drafted that script is we are worried that in a meeting that's starting here, we have guests who have never heard what Toastmasters is about. So when you are up here doing bilingual work, it's not easy to be up here, trust me, even to facilitate it. You forget a lot of information. So what was in the script that we created bilingually for both Mandarin and English Toastmaster was a description of what a meeting is, what Toastmaster is all about, and the functionary. Boom, just like that. And then each of the functionary, when you get up to talk about what you want to do, because it's a bilingual club, I'm thinking it's totally okay if you want to introduce your function in Mandarin or English. And again, because I've already mentioned that it does not have to be a direct translation each time, I do worry that because this is a bilingual club, all of us have come here to either improve our three things, our English, our Mandarin, and also our public speaking. Because that's the case, it is okay for us to come here and even listen. You don't need to be able to speak perfect English or perfect Chinese. You just need to get up here. And I think Allison is a great example of that. Those of us who are sitting there feeling a little uncomfortable, either because you have not perfected your Mandarin, perfected your public speaking yet, or perfected your English even, it is okay. This is the environment to do that with. And so the thing that will make things go smoother is that we will adhere to the manuals. The manuals are the things that Toastmaster give us to keep ourselves on track with timing. If the speech is a 4 to 6 minute speech, you aim for a 4 to 6 minute speech. If your speech is an 8 minute speech, you aim for 8 minutes. That is part of speech skills, to be able to control your timing on there too. And also, Toastmaster, you're doing a marvelous job because you are ahead of the group. If you find that the timing is really off according to this agenda, you have every power to say, let's keep this short, let's move on ahead, and so forth, okay? This way, the meeting goes smoothly, and we all learn from that. Other than that, I think this group is going forward really, really well. We are going to talk about leadership, meaning elections coming up. I'm going to leave that for maybe the next meeting to talk about that. At this point, I'm going to give you back to your Toastmaster, who will then give you back to your president, Alan and Kayla.
Personally, want to improve my Mandarin and my public speaking, which is why I'm here. I hope to hear more Mandarin. I think
Elliot.
Someone else. Okay. Anyhow, I want to improve my Mandarin. So, as Elliot said, it's more English heavy. I think I'll come again.
Yay!
Thank you.
Listening to you guys talk, so it's just so easy to forget if you don't use it every day. also want to come here to like meetings like this more often and use it in daily life. That way I can improve my manner, which improve it better. So I'll be coming back.
This was I enjoyed everyone's speeches and I like this setup. I didn't I actually was a little surprised. I didn't know that this is exactly what was going to happen. I like that you guys do speeches and get to hear a full talk. So it's really good practice, and I look forward to hearing more.